Welcome to Rangers TV Episode 0.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes. So, yes, we're here.
We've finally got onto video.
Yes. I'm Graffin.
And I'm V. And you've possibly heard of us on the radio show.
Yes, if you listen to our radio show.
But if not, go there.
Yes. At www.rangers.tk.
That's Rangers spelled R4nger5.
And you should see the URL at the bottom here.
About there.
So, yes, well, we've been doing a radio show for quite a while now, as we just plugged completely.
Yep, as we always do. Whenever I bump into someone that looks like they might be interested, I plug a radio show at them. And what we essentially do is we're big fans of a Canadian independent media sort of collective called Rant Media. And what we decided to do about a year ago is set up our own version of that with a UK flavour of it. And see if we could explore things in their philosophy and the idea of independent media and sort of thinking for yourself, you know, with more British and European based topics. So yeah, that's what we do. So we use generally use very, very cheap equipment.
We have used very cheap equipment.
Yes, in this case we are using very cheap equipment.
We are at the moment, that's why the quality isn't that great.
It will improve in the next episode because we just don't have the relevant bits to hand and we wanted to get it out to you as soon as possible.
We did, yes.
So you had an idea of what it is we wanted to do with Rangers TV.
Yep. So we've been doing a radio show for about a year now.
Mm-hmm.
We've got quite a decent listenership, I would say. Well, we say radio show, it's more of a podcast, although we prefer to call it an audio cast. Time. Yeah.
Webcast.
Audio cast, like that.
Yeah, we do an audio cast once a week, roughly.
Yep. When we're all ready, that is.
With varying degrees of success.
Yep. Episode 30 was just released last night.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's taken us about well over a year now, isn't it?
Yeah, it's about the 5th of June, isn't it? It's 5th
yeah.
of June.
Yep, it was about that time last year, I'm sorry.
About 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
Because the camera's so cheap, we need good light.
We do need good light, yes.
So, yes, that's good fun. And we feel we've got our chops together in planning out something and, you know, getting a piece of media out to people, and I think we've got a very good and loyal listenership. And if you listen to the radio show, hi, this is us. We're going to be producing a magazine in the next few months, which will sort of like be a compendium of all the things we've covered in the radio show, as well as all sorts of bits of writing. So if you want to send contributions to that, send it in. You know, send us in some written contributions or essays on anything you feel important, and that'd be good.
Yep.
We pretty much cover anything that comes up. You know, we'll take any news stories. Generally, we deal with lack of freedoms on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
We deal with new media that's coming out that's independent, tech news and stuff like that. And we've only got two rules.
Yes. No racism
and
no homophobia.
Those are the only two things because they are complete bollocks. But if you want to have a pop about anything else that winds you up, you know, where you go.
I mean, we had a pop of the Dalai Lama a few weeks ago.
Yeah, radio history. I'm fairly sure that's radio history. So, you know.
So, yes.
Well, we've done very well. We haven't sworn.
We have, yeah. We
no swearing.
Well, no, I swear quite
we
a bit.
Well, no, we haven't sworn on this.
Oh, we haven't sworn on this.
Yeah, we swear all the time on the radio show.
Yep.
But, you know, that's down to you.
Yes.
There's no such thing as a bad word.
No.
Your Uncle Sean. So, yeah.
Yep, well, history. Well, it was about a year ago, wasn't it? It was about a year and a half ago.
A couple of months.
Yeah. Year and a half ago, I'd been working for a particular company for a while, and so had V. And we happened to meet one time whilst we were smoking, and we got chatting. It turned out we were into quite a lot of the same stuff. And V introduced me to a TV show called Patrolling.
Very cool. So I literally stumbled on Patrolling via Shoutcast, and it's still there, in the Rant TV stream on Shoutcast. And they showed this TV show that basically covered a different kind of philosophy. It covered all sorts of sort of like tech stuff and sort of like, not necessarily just survival skills, but ways of getting through life that sort of made a lot more sense to me, and I really liked it. So there are two seasons of Patrolling, which is 22 episodes. It's well worth watching, so go there, and I'll be around here somewhere.
We'll have a link
Media
across the bottom, yeah.
So go along to Rant Media and check out their
Oh, excuse me. That's how you can tell we're doing this on
yep,
the
we're
cheap.
We're only doing one take.
Only one take.
So that's keeping it real.
Man.
Yes, so watch that. I was totally inspired by that, and I watched all of the Rant Media stuff that I could get my hands on, and eventually, as you always do, ran out. This is about 2 years ago. So it completely ran out of all Rant Media, and with any bunch of people producing media, it takes a long time.
Mm-hmm.
If those people are doing a job, it takes even longer. So it was like 2 months between an episode of Patrolling, you know, a week between each episode of Newsreel, which is the news program that they make. And it, you know, and it frustrated me. But then I sort of got my head around the whole concept that Ramp Media is about, is about people from the grassroots producing their own media. And the only way you can really get anything started is to do it yourself. So we decided to start doing a radio show, and our first attempts were awful. And
they were
lots of hassles, and it took us a long time to get the hang of it, and we just blared on for about an hour. And it was, you know, probably pretty boring. But as we did it more, we improved the standard of the radio show, got things a bit more organised, and went out to the dizzying heights of people actually liking our show. And we still get technical faults, because I don't really want to do many, many takes, and I only do a retake if we actually lose the recording, which happens from time to time.
It does. So it was about a year ago, well, just a couple of days before we...
Oh yes, we'd done the patrolling thing, and then we watched
Zeitgeist.
Oh, Zeitgeist.
Oh, wow, what a wonderful documentary that is.
And I'm afraid we're going to bore the piss out of you.
Yeah, the line
of text.
The link for Zeitgeist.
Go and watch it, but don't watch it on your own, and don't watch it, and don't do anything about it for about 24 hours.
No, it's imperative that once you've watched it, you do not do anything about it.
Stay in a cave for 24 hours and let it wash over you.
Yeah.
It is a pretty frightening film.
Yeah. So, V had already seen it, and he told me about it, so I went over here.
On the day we were going to record the first show.
Yep, and I watched it, and I spent about 12 hours feeling pretty angry. So I chilled out a bit, and then we recorded the first episode after that.
The following week.
Yeah, well...
Because we didn't dare record it straight after.
No, we didn't, it was the following week.
You mustn't do anything about your problem with the whole...
No, because you can't...
You really angry.
Yeah.
So, you know, that will be your homework if you're watching episode zero and you haven't already done it, go and watch Zeitgeist.
Yes.
To go on a little bit about Sean Kennedy and Samarian, the two guys that are sort of like the driving force behind Rant Media. Sean Kennedy's, just this guy, you know, who's come up with a few philosophies and a few points to live by. I don't always agree with everything he says. I think the guy's a complete star for doing what he's done. I enjoy listening to the media that he does put out, and I can't wait for more to come out when he does it. And Samarian is like the station manager and cameraman who does all the technical side of stuff and appears on the show and, you know, things like that. So, but they've come up with, you know, Sean actually tried to form an organisation a while back called Cult, which was a really interesting experiment in getting people with different skills to sort of like communicate with each other and get certain projects done. But unfortunately, in the way that largish organisations tend to do, it was all split up in fighting and stuff like that.
Yeah, it was, unfortunately.
We're kind of trying to do the same thing with the Rangers.
Yep.
In getting a media community together. You know, we're not aiming at any particular political point necessarily, although we do sort of like have a soft spot for libertarianism, actual like personal freedom of speech and thought and people being creative. So we're very into that, which is why we have the no racism and no homophobia rule. But Sean's basically, I think, it's only my personal opinion, was a little disillusioned by that, but him still carried on with Rant Media, which is great, and continues to this day. They've been going nearly 10 years now. And we really appreciate what they're doing, and it would be fantastic if at some point some of this maybe ended up on the Rant Media stream, like the Rangers Radio.
That'd be awesome, yeah.
So yeah, do you want to... We've got to define two terms now.
We do have to define two terms, and they're going to appear at the bottom. We have WOG and Rangers in our own spelling.
Yes.
Now, WOG is the original term that Sean Kennedy used to describe people like himself. He classed himself as a WOG and laid forth the WOG philosophy, which you will see if you watch Patrolling. Now, WOG is a derivative of polywog, or gollywog.
That's polywog.
Polywog, yeah. And L. Ron Hubbard, the leader of the Scientologists, decided to take that phrase, that word, WOG, and use it to describe everyone who isn't a Scientologist.
Yeah,
essentially like saying everyone's the meek. If you're not a Scientologist, you're a WOG, you're the meek, you're the downtrodden, you're going to be the slaves when a Scientologist take over.
And they really believe this.
They do really believe this.
Now, we're not, the whole idea behind what we're doing is we're not anti-Scientologist in the 100%. We're anti anybody that, you know, imposes their will on others for no good reason. So if, you know, you belong to an organisation that follows that, that imposes sort of bad things on ordinary people and expects them to take it, then we are going to be naturally opposing, because we believe in freedom of thought, speech, and the freedom to get your information out to someone, and, you know, the freedom to listen to any information or watch any stuff that you see fit.
Yeah.
So kind of like the WOG is the anti, is basically a celebration of like being an ordinary person and not of the ruling class, but someone that's I think he's moulded the term to be someone that's independent of thought and mind and able to solve problems as they come across it.
Exactly. Now, over here, unfortunately, over here, and in most of the ex-British colonies...
I would just say Commonwealth.
Well, Commonwealth, then.
All you colonials.
For anyone who's... any countries, like Hong Kong, possibly, and we're talking Australia,
Australia and New Zealand.
Australia and New Zealand and India. Wog is a racial slur.
Yeah, it's really something you don't want
to
be
it's,
using.
It's a
in
bad
parlance.
Word to use. So we decided that we can't call ourselves Wogs. We need to call ourselves something else.
And it took a long time to come up with something.
It did. It takes a long time to come up with a word that you feel proud to use. So we ended up with Rangers, with the slightly leaked spelling. Not 100% leaked, but slightly leaked spelling. So there is a technical slant on it.
That neat is about, you know, is about as out of date as emoticons, really.
Yeah.
But that just shows how old we're becoming.
Yes.
And so it's R4nger5, which is kind of like a slightly weird spelling of it. But it implies that we're sort of, you know, the whole Rangers idea, sort of like, you know, like Army Rangers or, you know, there's loads of sort of like use of it, like, you know, a little bit to do with like the Babylon 5 Rangers.
Yep. You've got the...
You know, so they're kind of like people that can act independently and achieve goals. Is what we were trying for, and then the leaked spelling is on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
Amusingly enough, it's also the name of Sean Kennedy's dog.
It is as well, isn't it? Yeah.
Which is like kind of another aspect of it. It's like kind of tongue in cheek.
Mm-hmm.
So that we don't really take ourselves overly seriously, except, you know, at a very personal level where we, you know, cling to our politics and sort of like explore what we are as people and try and do interesting things in our lives, because you might not get another chance at it, and you might as well be learning and doing interesting stuff while you're killing time.
Yep.
And the philosophy is, if we can do it for nothing, or do it for very little money,
we'll
do it that way. We're not going to spend loads and loads of money on the TV show. We're not going to encourage you to spend loads of money. If we can save you a few quid here and there, we will. If we can come up with a really cheap, completely easy way of doing something, we'll let you know about it. Yeah. And so kind of that's what we want from the TV show. We want to try and show you how to do things. Kind of like... there used to be a program in the UK called Why Don't You? And they would show you interesting things to do as opposed to watching television.
Yep.
Which is kind of ironic, because you're watching television to find out useful things.
Well, exactly,
but
yeah.
Anyway, we enjoy doing things like going camping and hiking. We enjoy playing around with computer systems. We've both got a fetish for getting old computer equipment to do stuff usefully.
We are.
You know, if we can recover a piece of equipment or recover a piece of kit or make it, we will. As long as it's better than a reasonably priced piece of kit that will do the same job.
Yep.
So like, for instance, when we go camping, rather than bring a big marquee along, we build a shelter out of tarpaulins when we get there. That's like one example. If we can hack something together and make it do something that it wasn't ordinarily going to do, we'll do it like that. We like the idea of actual hackers, not the people that wreck computer systems, but the people that come up with new ways to do things.
Yep.
And what we want from the TV show is you guys to actually send stuff to us, you know, illustrations of you doing your thing. If you've got like hints and tips or things we can try or record on the TV show, you don't even have to film it.
No,
if you come up with a cool idea and you can explain it sufficiently to us that
we'll do it for you.
We will do
and
it.
And give you credit.
Yeah.
Give you all the credit.
And if you produce a piece of footage that shows you doing this thing, we will include it in the TV show. So it's kind of like as open source television as we can make it without people hacking it to bits and making us look like more than
yes.
than we look like idiots to start with.
So yes, well, this episode is about, well, it's generally a glorified test card, something a bit more interesting than just a test card. I finished doing the intro and outro for the show yesterday.
And we really wanted to use them.
We really wanted to use them, so we're doing this now to put it up on YouTube, just to introduce ourselves, especially to those of you who do listen to our radio show, to show this as a test. Now, this is being done on a very low quality...
Oh, it's a really horribly cheap camera.
Really cheap, low quality camera.
It's only just above a webcam.
Yeah. And just for this particular episode, because I can't find my FireWire cable, but when I do find that, we'll be using a proper mini DV camera for all the recording, which should give us better quality. Well, it will definitely give us better quality. That's it, really. This episode is just us pootling about, and we're going to show you something we think is... really a major point.
Yes, it's kind of like an essential piece of, essential collection of kit that you should really have on you most of the time. Not necessarily those entire things, but the ideas of those things and sort of be able to solve the problems that those things solve without going too much into it. You want to go about licensing?
Oh yes, of course, got that. Yes, Before I forget, and this will be repeated at the end, right at the end of the program.
And every episode.
End of every episode, yes. This is under a Creative Commons license. It's under a attribution, non-commercial, non-derivative works license, unported. So that means that you can share it with everyone, as long as you give us kudos and credits for it. You can't sell it, and you can't make any derivative works without our express permission. So if you see what we've done and you would like to edit
it... By derivative, we mean don't chop it up and re-edit it and pass it off as your own work.
Yeah.
The other idea of derivative is that you make something similar, go for it.
Yeah.
Really go for
it. If you want to make like a parody or a pastiche or anything like that, go for it.
Yeah. You're free to make things that are like it, you're not,
yeah,
just not really free
illusions,
to edit
fine,
it in other ways.
Yeah.
But, you know. We look forward to hearing from you, and if you're going to send us stuff, ideally, don't send us anything that's been on YouTube elsewhere, because
mm-hmm.
we're trying to produce original content, so we're not going to bore people who've gone,
yeah,
I've already seen this. It's literally so that your stuff gets properly watched.
Yeah.
So do a new recording if you want to send it in, or write, you know, if you can do something and you want us to film us doing it, then that's cool too.
Yep.
But we'd like original content, so literally, you sit down in front of a webcam. You know, it doesn't matter, you know, how sort of jerky or moving, we will include it on the show because we want to see what you people want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, because you can't really do that with television unless you're prepared to make yourself look like an idiot. So nobody wants to learn anything from someone sitting in front of, you know, their computer at home or sitting, you know, in their garden. Nobody wants to learn how to do anything anymore, really, it seems, apart from the sort of people that sort of generally end up watching Rant Media.
Yep.
So this is like our salute to Rant Media and us getting off our asses, well, we're still on our asses, but us getting off our asses metaphorically,
mm-hmm.
and making some TV, because it is difficult, it does take a long time, but you know, you can only encourage people to do it by doing it yourself.
Yep.
So we're going to cover Beltline Kit, which is a collection of stuff you kind of should have with you all the time, and the sort of things we carry around with us all the time to allow us to solve our problems, and to sort of like sort out things the way we would otherwise have to go and sort of like pay money to get things done.
Mm-hmm.
So yes. So welcome, it's great, Rangers TV episode 0,
yep.
And we'll be back after we've done, you know, we'll do another shot of us sitting around and saying goodbye at the end of the piece on Beltline Kit.
Yeah, we're just going to probably have a fade right now, just...
Yeah, and it'll look all very fussy and interesting, honestly.
Okay then, well, first of all, I'm going to do my Beltline Kit, which consists of, and this is all stuff that's on my belt.
And this is stuff we genuinely do carry
this
everywhere.
Genuinely,
not
we
messing
do
with
carry
it.
This everywhere.
And as you were looking at us, as you're looking at us earlier, the whole black combat thing, we genuinely do wander around.
We all
were, because
we're
sad.
Okay, so we have a little Zippo lighter pouch, a cell phone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, see, don't show the branding, but you said Zippo. That's okay.
That's true. That's true, because it's just, that's
well, say the brand names of anything that's genuinely cool and it's a good vantage.
A Leatherman.
A Leatherman Wave, to be precise.
Yep. I don't know if I can get this off my belt. My other pouch. Which I will show you the contents of. Okay, so in here, this is my normal pouch. This is actually a side office made by Night Eyes. I haven't actually decided whether this is any good yet, but I'm liking it at the moment. So in here, I haven't really got much except for my HTC Universal PDA, a 1.5 watt LED torch, very bright,
mm-hmm.
and a pen, because pens are always useful. In my pockets I have yon bus pass, a wallet, my little gemstone pouch, which includes a piece of Moldavite. If for those of you who've seen patrolling, will know what that is. And my ranger badge with my keys.
Yes, a ranger badge is essentially a lanyard.
Mm-hmm.
So if you've heard people alluding to the ranger badge, that's what they mean. It's actually a 1 meter lanyard which comprises 6 meters of paracord.
Yep.
So if you combine the paracord with the knife and all the other goodies, you could possibly build yourself a shelter out of what you're carrying around.
One last thing, because I do smoke, a tin of tobacco.
Yep. We smoke. It's bad. We know.
Mm-hmm. So that's my Beltline kit.
Yes. You filled up the table.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So now we'll do my Beltline kit.
There we go.
Right. I am really, really paranoid about sort of not having what I need, because I've been in lots of situations where I haven't had what I need. So I have a Leatherman Wave with a keyring attachment on it, which makes it easier to attach to yourself if you're going to be wandering about in the woods. You can bang a length of paracord on that. The Leatherman Wave comes with a lanyard attachment, so I just put a keyring on that. I carry a scary amount of lighters. That one has a torch on it. That's a butane flame lighter, a backup emergency lighter that I can afford to give away or lose, or just, you know, use up to light a campfire. A copy of a Zippo lighter, because
which is just as good, really.
To be honest, the copies, if you go into, like, well, in the UK we have pound shops. If you go into the pound shop, you'll be able to get those for a pound. They last forever. You can drop them down mountainsides, and the advantage over an actual Zippo lighter is people won't try and steal it, which has been my experience a lot of the time. I have another belt pouch which contains, which has got a pocket on the front for CDs and media. I also have an XDA PDA,
which is again the HTC Universal,
which you can produce Word documents, spreadsheets. You can put together, you can shoot video on it. You can take still photographs. You can listen to your media on it, watch movies on it, all sorts of really cool stuff. It's like a baby laptop, basically. Oh, and you can pick up your emails on it and surf broadband wirelessly or using the mobile phone linkage. So it's very, very cool for a lot of things. And it saves carrying around a laptop in places where people would be suspicious of the laptop. It's a little bulky with the extra battery, but it's worth the extra weight over the phone because of all the things it does. I always carry like a notebook and a couple of pens. One of these pens is a CD pen, which I try and keep to hand because you never know when you're going to have to write on media or produce something for someone. I have, I'm clipping it, my Ranger badge, with, sometimes it has a Swiss Army knife on it, sometimes it doesn't. I smoke, that's the Scruffin, so I've got my tobacco tin. I carry a wallet. I don't seem to be filling the table as much as you do.
No, I believe my thing was quite big.
And when I'm camping, this is one of my favourite pieces of equipment ever. A Falkniven F1 Swedish survival knife. So we covered everything. Yeah. Okay, out of this, the only really, really important things for solving problems outside of your keys and your wallet and all the stuff you normally might carry around are a knife, and I'd say the Leatherman Wave because it covers all sorts of other things. It's got about 20 different tools on it. A lighter, and I'd go with the butane torch because it lasts for ages. You can fill it up really cheaply and easily, and it never loses flints or anything. It's piezoelectric ignition. And, yes. Because I'm more of a cheapskate than Graffin, that's a Maglite copy from a pound shop, which has served me well for about 5 years. It takes two AA batteries, got one ordinary sort of like little grain of wheat bulb in it. Yes. So yes, I'd say knife, lighter and torch are probably the most important things you can have on a Beltline kit. They'll all fit in a small pouch, but this replaces carrying a bag or anything like that, apart from the extra knives, which I generally habitually carry when I'm out hiking. So that's my Beltline kit.
Well, that's it from us today.
Yep.
That was episode 0 of Ranger's TV.
I hope you enjoyed the bit on the Beltline kit.
Yep.
We didn't want to produce an episode that didn't have any content in it at all.
Exactly.
Nice blaring.
Yeah.
We hope that you found it interesting, and I hope that this will make you maybe look forward to a much better quality and much better laid out episode 1.
Oh, yes.
Thanks very much.
Take care.